Hello viewers and welcome to another episode of Shujaa right here on WTV Kenya. I'm your host, Linda Kruger. Now remember, this is the show where we celebrate individuals or even organizations that are going above and beyond to make a positive impact in society. Today we are looking at the youth. And with me on set, I have Edwin Thoita. Welcome to Shujaa.
Thank you.
Now, Edwin is the founder of To Hustle, and he's going to be telling us a little bit more about what his organization is doing to impact the youth and Kenyan society positively. Maybe we can start off, you know, give us a basic understanding of what To Hustle is all about.
Well, To Hustle is a youth empowerment program. Like the name says, it's a combination of two words, To and Hustle, which means let's hustle.
Oh, yeah.
Basically, it is a call for the youth to start chasing their dreams at an early age.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's exactly what we do.
Wonderful. When did you start To Hustle?
We registered the company like a year ago, but most of the time has been spent on fixing the background details to ensure that we have a solid structure.
Oh yeah, a solid foundation.
We have been running for like 3 months.
Wow, that's great. And when you were coming up with the company, what was the what's the main mission, the basic driving force behind To Hustle?
Our main goal is to battle youth unemployment by challenging the youth to mold themselves into who they want to become in the future.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. I mean, let's have a candid conversation about that, Edwin. And how old are you?
I'm 21, turning 22 in December.
Imagine that. And you were able to see that, you know, we have a gap in society. What do you think is our biggest issue in terms of having our youth become, you know, self-employed or even employed and actively working for a better future right now?
In my opinion, the biggest problem we have is that the people, the elderly, they were like, the grown-ups, they don't like to give a chance to the youth more. They think that they're still not able to chase their dreams. Mm-hmm. Another problem with the youth is that they think it's too early.
Mm-hmm.
So they party, they do things, and then when they come to realize, it's too late. Mm-hmm. But it's never too late.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's amazing. So at 21, actually younger, if it's been in operation for about a year, at 20, you come up with a company. How did you go about it would be the first question, you know, maybe to the young people watching. Did you do it on your own? Were you a bunch of friends?
Well, my best friend and I, who my best friend is also the managing director for the company.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, he was not able to be here today.
Mm-hmm.
My best friend and I were seated once at home, and then we had all these amazing ideas of what we can do if we had resources or something. Then we realized there's no way we can get these resources. So we asked ourselves, how many other people outside there have this problem? So we came up with an idea. Having that idea, we started smallly. We have been saving kidogo, so we've put some cash to start. So that's the basic idea for the how we came up with the idea.
Amazing. So did you do it on your own?
Yeah, just me and him.
Any let's say advisors, you know,
I have
in the market.
I have a mentor, he's called Mr. John.
Mm-hmm.
He's not only my mentor, but he gave me some cash, but more importantly, he directed me towards what I'm going, where I'm headed.
Mm-hmm.
He's been telling me what to do, what not to do, and he's been giving me advice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I can say he's the only person I can call my mentor now, and he's the only person who knows the journey about To Hustle.
Amazing. And you're making wonderful strides. So tell us about how To Hustle is impacting the youth. What is your strategy on helping other young people?
Well, our target is young entrepreneurs who have started something. You know, when you're young and you start something, you'll definitely have financial problems.
Mm-hmm.
So our aim is to meet sponsors and donors to give us these finances, and then we can spread them to the youth who need them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. So have you managed to interact, you know, with young people?
Yeah. We have received like 200 applications.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, we interact via email, some via our social media, and we've even funded one application.
Great. Maybe you can share with us what application you've shared it and why that specific one to start off from the 200.
The company, the application that we have funded is for an event organization company mm-hmm. that does the K-Cart, mm-hmm. the K-Cart
affair.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so they sent in an application. There's a panel that checks out the applications, and then judging from what they have done and the strides they have made, the 200 applications that were sent in, theirs stood out.
Mm-hmm. How exactly did it stand out? We'd love to know more about that.
Because they have something registered, they have something running, mm. and they have been going. So they have profits. They have been making something. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the other 200 applications are people who have not started yet. They are people who want to start.
Just ideas.
Yeah, just ideas. So we picked K-Cart because they have started already.
Wow! Amazing. So you have this panel and you have all these 200 applicants and you pick one. What happens from there?
After the application is picked that this is the one that is going to be funded, we have a meeting with them and the panel. Mm-hmm. So they explain their future strides, what they want to do, how they will use the money, the terms of repayment, or how the company will benefit from putting in funds in their application. Yeah.
Okay, so in essence, To Hustle then becomes like a sort of investment group.
Yeah.
You know, you're giving them funds and they get repaid.
Yeah, but more importantly, we also try to get people who are good in the field that the people for receiving funds mm-hmm. are, mm-hmm. and then we try to connect them and then get mentorship from these people mm-hmm. so that they can know where they're going wrong, where they're going right before they receive the funds.
Amazing.
So they sort of like get directions before on what to do and what not to do before they get the funds.
Mm-hmm. So it goes above and beyond just investment.
Yeah.
That's great. So To Hustle then becomes a sort of incubator and in developing, you know, business concepts and ideas and even actual businesses in place. So how exactly have you managed to reach out to more youth across the country and not just, you know, Nairobi? Because we've seen a lot of initiatives and companies concentrate their activities within Nairobi. How do you plan to, or how have you, reached out to other people in other areas?
Like we said, we have only been running for 2 to 3 months. So we are trying to get marketing advisors and people who, we actually right now, there's a marketer who is doing marketing for us. So every morning we put on social, we are doing social media marketing.
Mm-hmm.
So we just do social media first because our funds are limited. So mm-hmm. we can't pull out some big marketing firm. So we're just doing social media mm-hmm. for now.
Wonderful. And I mean, digital marketing is the next thing. So doesn't necessarily mean you're not doing well.
We're doing all right.
That's wonderful. So why did you pick the youth, Edwin? I know you're a young person, but you know, plenty of opportunities, plenty of areas to focus on. But why focus on the youth?
Truth be told, it was hard for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I realized it is hard for other youth. Mm-hmm. So I decided to stick with the youth.
Mm-hmm. So from personal experience?
Yes, personal experience.
Along the journey, have you met people who've tried to, you know, bring you down and redirect your efforts?
Yeah, there's always people like that.
Uh-huh.
But you don't listen. It is said a cow does not, a donkey cannot, does drinks water even if the frogs are...
I'm making
noise.
Yeah. 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 Sure. With us, an experience maybe that you've had for our young guests who are watching our young viewers who are watching to be able to relate.
An example is my friends. Every time I get some money, I always tell them of how I want to grow this to become something big. But no, my friends are like, no, say it's too early to start putting in funds, let's do this, let's do that. So they try to show you that you're too young to do something, but truth is, you should. I think everyone who tells you not to do something, but you believe, the most important thing is believing in yourself. If you believe you'll make it, you'll make it. But don't listen to everyone. But there are also people who give you good advice.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So you should. Yeah, you should keep those close.
Wonderful. Now, as we wind up this first part of our conversation, we have the government recently putting in a focus on the youth, women, and persons living with disabilities, and we have funds that have not yet been dispersed to young people. Why do we have that gap? You know, previously before that, we said that there weren't any opportunities. Mm-hmm. But now the government goes ahead and gives us about 800 million plus for, you know, registered companies to the youth, among others. So why don't we have our young people grabbing at these opportunities?
I actually tried to get the funds from the government. Uh-huh. Believe me, it is a long process.
Oh, and yeah. Maybe and you before, can share with us,
Before you get the funds, it will take you a while, so most people give up. Because mm-hmm. you have to go queue, you have to do things, there are documents they require, and then most people get tired. Mm-hmm. So that breaks down to most youth are also not serious. Mm-hmm. So given the opportunity, they don't want to take it. Yeah, but the biggest barrier with government funds is it becomes hard to get. They say that the money is there, but when you try and get the money, you don't get it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what was your experience? Yeah? What was your experience, you know, going there, presenting your idea and asking for all this money?
Okay, I queued, they asked for documents, they asked for registration documents, they asked for what. I brought all the documents. And then I left the document with the person they asked me to leave the document with. And then they told me, mm-hmm. They'll give me a confirmation on what next. So I've been pursuing the person, and then they're saying that it's still not forthcoming.
Okay, yeah, all right.
So it takes, if you want to give up, you'd have given up already.
Mm-hmm. So you think the youth give up on such opportunities?
The youth are not persistent enough.
Mm-hmm. And not serious also in other cases. All right, thank you very much, Edwin. Ladies and gentlemen, we're taking a short break. Keep it Shujaa on WTV Kenya. Hello viewers, and welcome back to Shujaa for a Better Kenya. We celebrate individuals and organizations doing exceedingly well to improve the lives of their community and Kenya at large. Today I'm focusing on the youth, and with me on set is Edwin Thwite, founder of To Hustle. Welcome back. Now I'm looking at your profile here, and there's one very interesting aspect, I believe, to your company, and this is one a vision for a Kenya where youth employment, unemployment, is a minimalized problem, and uniting of young minds. And my question comes in with knowledge. What is the importance of knowledge in and education in business?
Importance of knowledge and education in business.
Oh yeah.
Like we all know, knowledge gives a better perspective of things. Mm-hmm. So it is said that people who are more knowledgeable tend to think more about things and their outcome. Mm-hmm. Like I'll give you an example. A school dropout outside there will think about robbing people. Mm-hmm. He or she will not think about the outcome of what?
Of their actions.
Of their actions.
Oh, yeah.
But a knowledgeable person, a person who has gone to school, will know if I do this and this, this will happen, and I don't want this to happen. So, you know, also in business, if you learn something in school, you'll be able to apply it in your business.
Mm-hmm. Amazing. And how exactly does your organization, being that you're not just investing and sponsoring these young businesses, but you're also motivating them, mentoring them, and, you know, adding more knowledge, how are you going about that?
As we progress, we would like to have meetings where we bring the youth together and then bring someone to speak to them and tell them, or us also, and tell and share with them our experiences of how we've come about and everything. We would like to bring conferences where the youth come together and share ideas.
Mm-hmm. Amazing. Now, we have young people across all divides, and there have been in the past, and even from our daily conversations, what we hear on the radio, what we hear on the streets, who affirm that they feel left out from a lot of things. And this brings in the other question about bridging the divide between young people across all divides, you know, proper homes, proper financial situations, to those who are at a disadvantaged position, and what your company is offering them and what the government is already doing on the ground. How do you plan on, you know, bringing everybody, all the stakeholders together to bring a better improvement in the area?
Okay, first of all, we've made being part of To Hustle really easy. So anyone from anywhere can join To Hustle. Mm-hmm. And then we would like to approach the government, but not now. We'd like to we would like them to see that there's something we're doing. We'd like to have youth come together first, mm-hmm. then share our ideas, share everything. Then after, we can approach the government who will help us unite the whole country together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amazing, and we wish you all the best with that. So moving on, what are some of the unique startups that you're looking to bring in to Hustle?
Something about us as to Hustle, we do not have a line of what startups we want to we tell them the ball is in your court. You tell us, we would like everyone to be themselves. Mm-hmm. We would like you to tell us, I'm good at this, I'm good at, I feel this is what I want to do. We don't want to tell you must do this or you're not part of to Hustle. So we would like anyone and everyone to be themselves and tell us what they, if something unique comes up, we'll definitely put it out.
Amazing. So it's basically open to all sorts of ideas and business.
That's why we're saying we will soon unify people.
Oh yeah, all the way. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're listening. It's open to all sorts of business ideas and startups. And another question that would come in is, we're having a lot of attention going into entrepreneurship. I'm sure you've heard of the upcoming television shows about the KCB Lions then. We have another one in the works. What would make yours unique from such, you know, giants, really? What's your plan to make sure that yours stands out and, you know, continues on that line of positively impacting young people?
What makes us unique is because we're not giants. We are simple people who know simple problems, and most Kenyans are simple people, mm-hmm. so they would also like something simple, so that's our uniqueness.
All right, maybe you can go into a bit more details for us.
Okay, but like I explained, it's simple to join. These giants, they have processes in which you have to join them. That can be a hassle for someone from maybe Garissa or, you see. But us, since we're doing digital and online, anyone, you don't have to come to Nairobi to share your idea. Mm-hmm. You can just do it via your mobile, you can go to an internet cafe, send an email, then you can go through it. So it is simple to put
it. Oh yeah, you're taking it the digital way. That's wonderful, Edwin. Now, mentorship is one of your key pillars. And to be very honest, it's been the in thing. I call it the in thing. Everybody's talking about mentorship. How do you plan on executing it, one? And two, really, how do you ensure its longevity? And also that you're adding value from the mentors to the mentees?
Okay, mentorship will be the hassle for the company. Mm-hmm. Us as the directors and we'll be finding successful people, mm-hmm. who want to share their ideas. We will not just connect the youth with the mentors and tell them, yo, go to this person.
Yeah.
No, we'll have to talk to this mentor first, find out what field they are at, and then collect the people who want to join this field and then hook them up. Yeah.
And how will you manage to do, you know, a follow-up and ensure that, you know, what's been passed on from the mentor to the mentee is actually valuable?
Since we're using digital marketing, and we will keep in touch with these people who have registered via email, via texts. We ask for their contact information when they are applying. Mm-hmm. So we keep track of what they're doing every day via communication. Mm-hmm. So if we can ask, how is it going with your mentor? What do you think is adding value? So basically, to Hustle is what makes you become a better you. Mm-hmm. If you tell us we don't think this mentor is adding value to me, we can switch up a mentor, yeah, like that. So it is, we cannot say you'll have this mentor for 3 months and you have to have this mentor for 3 months. Mm-hmm. You can sit with your mentor. If you feel he's not adding value, you can come to us and tell us, this person, so and so, could you find me someone who this. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, wonderful. Now, you have gone through mentorship. Maybe you can tell us, what are the key values that have been added to you via your mentor and vice versa?
The first value that was added to me by the mentor was patience. Mm-hmm. I was told nothing happens at once. You cannot have a dream today, work on it tomorrow, and then expect to be successful the third day. Mm-hmm. You have to be patient. You have to be persistent. You have to work. You have to work the details. You have to work hard. Be patient. Okay. My mentor has told me. Okay. Has added values that everyone else keeps telling you. Mm-hmm. The uniqueness about him mm-hmm. is that he keeps following up. Mm-hmm. He keeps following up. He keeps asking me, "What have you done today? What are you going to do tomorrow? What are your plans for next week?" Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so a value I can say I've added to my mentor is trust. Because mm-hmm. at first, you see, I just walked up to him and told him, "I think you're successful. From an outside look, outside point of view, I think you're successful and I'd like to be as successful as you. Could you please show me?" So he was like, "You cannot just come to me like that and then tell me things and then expect me to just roll in like that." So I think trust is
what you've been brought to him. That's amazing. Now, we're going to a green era as much as we're going to a digital era. And sustainability and sustainable businesses are some of the things that, you know, majority of the people are looking into. Has To Hustle taken that up as one of its driving forces?
We do not have a steady source of income. There's an application fee of 200 shillings mm-hmm. which the applicant must pay to us. It is not steady. Our main source of income would like to come from sponsors and donors who think this is an initiative that helps the youth, that is trying to bring a better youth, so they sponsor us with their funds. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What happens in a situation where, because we've seen this happening a lot with non-governmental organizations, community-based organizations, initiatives and the like, where we don't have a steady flow of sponsorship and donor money, what then for To Hustle? What would be some of the ventures that you could get into to be to have the aspect of sustainability within the company?
Well, at the moment, we have not thought about ventures that we can go into just yet. Mm-hmm. Our goal right now is to have these youth come together, share ideas, and then try and grow something. Mm-hmm. If it works out and we see the youth are doing something, then we can figure out what ventures to go into.
All right. So it's definitely in the works and in the plans.
We have only been running for 3 months.
Oh yeah. And truly making amazing strides. We're now winding up our interview, Edwin, and we like to know, 5-10 years, where can we see, or where should we expect to see To Hustle?
To Hustle will have created employment for more than 1,000 people. That is a five-year goal. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we would like to see 1,000 people making their own money in 5 years. Wow. And working hard.
I like that. Set goals and we hope you get to them. And maybe you can look into your camera and leave a word of advice to young people watching who, you know, are in the struggle. The other day we saw somebody walking around with an advertisement billboard. So tell something to the young people watching who feel that they are not getting where they need to be.
I don't want to sound cliche and say a lot of things, but I just want to say there's no perfect time or situation to start chasing your dreams. Everything is possible if you believe in yourself, so start now.
Mm-hmm. Start now. Thank you very much, Edwin Peter, for joining us. We wish you all the best with To Hustle. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Shujaa. We've been focusing on young people and we've been highlighting To Hustle. I've had with me on set Edwin Peter, the founder of To Hustle Company, a company that picks up young people who are starting up businesses. You've picked up a pointer or two and we'll be reaching out to them to improve and take your business to the next level. I've been your host, Linda Kruger. Keep it WTV Kenya, same time, same place.